हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज़ गुरप्रीत सिंह। आई एम वर्किंग ए असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फार्मास्यूटिकल केमिस्ट्री एट ISF कॉलेज ऑफ फार्मेसी। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डेमोन्स्ट्रेट अ प्रैक्टिकल बेस्ड ऑन कॉलम क्रोमेटोग्राफी। दिस इज़ फॉर फार्मडी थर्ड ईयर एंड फॉर द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ फार्मास्यूटिकल एनालिसिस। कॉलम क्रोमेटोग्राफी। कॉलम क्रोमेटोग्राफी वॉज डिवेल्प्ड बाई अमेरिकन केमिस्ट डी टी डे इन 1900 एंड एम एस ट्वेट्स इन ए पॉलिश बोटेनिस्ट इन 1906। दे सेपरेट द क्लोरोफिल एंड जेंथोफिल फ्रॉम ग्रीन प्लांट्स। कॉलम क्रोमेटोग्राफी इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट यूजफुल मेथड फॉर द सेपरेशन एंड प्योरीफिकेशन ऑफ बोथ सॉलिड एंड लिक्विड मिक्सचर्स। इट्स ए सॉलिड लिक्विड टेक्निक इन विच स्टेशनरी फेज इज ए सॉलिड एंड मोबाइल फेज इज ए लिक्विड। There are other techniques like solid gas chromatography and solid liquid chromatography like HPLC. The principle for the column chromatography is adsorption. The mixture of component is dissolved in the mobile phase or the solvent and introduced into the column. The component moves down the column depending upon their relative affinity toward the stationary phase. Adsorption column chromatography use a adsorbent which is generally packed in a glass column and use mobile phase which is a liquid as a eluent. The compound having more affinity for the mobile phase will move rapidly through the column and elute it first, and the while which have more affinity towards the stationary phase will elute it later. This is a diagrammatic representation of a column chromatography in which we have a glass column. At the bottom of the glass column we have placed a glass wool and cotton plug. This cotton plug prevent the movement of adsorbent bed or the stationary phase through the column. Upon that we have packed the adsorbent up to minimum required amount, and then we have placed our mixture of components. After our mixture of compound is adsorbed on the adsorbent bed, we place a cotton plug, and after that solvent is run through the column. The collecting vessel for the eluent are small conicals or the beakers. Now the experimental aspects for the column chromatography. First, we need a adsorbent which act as stationary phase. Commonly employed adsorbents are silica, alumina, calcium carbonate, calcium phosphate, starch, magnesia. Alumina is suitable for chromatography of less polar compounds, while silica is used for polar functional groups. Now, the basic requirement for the adsorbent: the particle size should be spherical and uniform shape. It should have high mechanical stability, chemically inert, and the particle size for commercially available grade adsorbents are 50 to 200 micrometers. The selection of stationary phase is based upon these following parameters. First is number of components to be separated, length of column used, affinity between the components, and quality of the adsorbent used. Now the mobile phase, it acts as developing agent. It is used to introduce the mixture of component into column, and it acts as eluent for the elution of the pure components. We have shown different mobile phase which can be used in the increasing order of polarity, that is petroleum ether with the lowest polarity, then CCl4, cyclohexane, ether, acetone, benzene, toluene, esters and water which has highest polarity. They can be used in pure form or either as a mixture of one or two solvents. Next is the column characteristics. The main function of all is column is to support the stationary phase. The column are generally made up of glass which is non-reactive. A burette can also serve as the purpose of column for the separation. The column dimensions, length into diameter ratio should be 10:1, 30:1 or 100:1. The various accessories can be attached at the bottom or the top of the column for maintenance of elution process. The length of column depends upon number of component to be separated, type of the adsorbent used, quantity of sample, affinity of compound toward the adsorbent, and for better separation we use long narrow column with short thick column, because there are more number of hypothetical plates. There are two commonly used technique for the column chromatographic column. There are dry packing or dry filling or wet packing. So Before performing the experiment, we need a column of desired length, silica gel 60 to 120 mesh size as stationary phase, mobile phase such as hexane and other solvents, collecting vessels for fractions from the column, small conicals. Next, we require a funnel, pipette, dropper and small amount of cotton or glass wool. Place a cotton plug at the bottom of the column. This will allow the stationary phase to retain in the column. Place a funnel at the top. We are using dry packing for this and allow the stationary phase to flow through it. Remove the funnel, give a gentle tap to the column so that stationary phase could be settled down, and make a uniform bed and air entrap should be exuded. Add more of stationary phase if required. And give a gentle tap again to settle down the stationary phase to make it uniform. Adsorbent. Now our adsorbent bed is settled. Dissolve the sample in the least polarity solvent and take the sample in a pipette or a dropper and allow it to flow through the walls of the column and allow it to adsorb on the adsorbent bed. Open the tap from the bottom. Add a small piece of cotton above the absorbent bed. Place a collecting vessel at the bottom and add solvent to the column. The adsorbent bed should remain undisturbed while adding the solvent. As the solvent flows through the column, the components start separating and they will form either band or separated as a mixture. You can see a yellow band start forming in the column, and the fractions can be collected into small beakers or small conicals.
As the solvent runs down the column, it will elute the mixture of components into different separate bands. As you see, can here, here is a yellow band which is appearing as mixture. The fractions coming out from the column can be collected in small beakers, that is usually in 10 to 25 ml range, or you can use conical flask. If the component present in the mixture are color, you can easily visualize by its color, and if they are colorless, then we have to do the TLC analysis. Here we have run a TLC, that is here we are representing a TLC that is taken from the eluents from the column. You can see there is no pure component. There are mixture of 1 and 2 or maybe 3 components. The same, the fractions containing same component can be pooled together and they can be concentrated, and column can be rerun to obtain the pure component. The column can be, column chromatography can be performed many times until we have a pure compound. It is very time consuming, it's a very tedious process. You require a lot of patience to do this, and you require a more amount of mobile phase and automation techniques are quite expensive and complicated. Thank you.